older person who's been through something gives us that perspective. Like, oh fuck yeah, oh fuck, can I say fuck? I said fuck. Anyway.
Press the bell icon and never miss an update from Digital Hash.
No, it wasn't. We only focused on the first season, and once it got done and received well, it gave us confidence that okay, second season we can do it, and there's enough meat, enough story in the characters to take forward. We were told that whatever duration we took was better than industry standards, and I felt great. So just to answer, we wrapped it up in less than 3 months. Yeah. Given the time crunch we had, the production schedule, 2.5 months tops from the first draft to the final draft, with all the punch-ups involved.
I think a majority of what we was on paper did make it to screen, and which again, like you mentioned, was satisfactory. But also what I liked is that actors improvised some of the lines, which I think was also interesting to watch. Some of the points that they brought up were like, okay, that's interesting. So what we wrote was there, but I think as writers, we gave enough room to the actors and the directors to sort of do their thing without being too rigid and saying, nay, my word is the last word.
And I remember when we were writing, especially the 5th and 6th episode, where most of the learning and the gyan comes, and the gyan helps solve the problems and differences. I at least personally wasn't sure of what impact would those words have, because they were common day knowledge that everybody knows. Okay, you know, love others, accept others, and I was a little apprehensive about how impactful it will come across on screen. But kudos to the actors and the directors; they made the scenes emotional and not too heavy again. So enough take back from those scenes. So pretty happy. I just think we lost out on some of the humor scenes, the comedy that we wrote, just to balance the story out. But again, we had 20-25 minutes, so I'm sure
it
was the right call. I have two names. One, Anita, because in the first season, she was not with the main family and she only spent time with them during one episode. So her character could not have been fleshed out much. But in second season, she really killed it. At least I think she had enough a meaty role to play. And now I think that if at all we highlight on what her previous life has been, how did she and Nikhil meet, would make a good story. And I think even Kriti the actress, Shreya is the name of the character, she comes across as smart, suave, more modern age, practical, still vulnerable, things a lot of us relate to. So I'm sure a story on her would make for good viewership.
Yeah, agree with what he said. I'll tell you, Anand wants to write like this mad-ass comedy.
Yes, I always join this creative world to write comedy, make people laugh. So, and the first season allowed me to do that a bit. But next, if the chance permits, the Dice Media can work out an out-and-out comedy, more people-based, more dialogue-based comedy than situations, than slapstick. So yeah, I'd like to take a shot at that.
I'm pretty happy writing this slice of life series, but I'd really like to write something that's a little gritty and dark and dirty, I guess. That's the word.
Eventually, I would want to do dark stuff, yes.
I think the good thing is that no genre has been able to define it, and there's space for everything right now, which is why we can write a slice of life, but we can also aim to write something a little gritty or something that's out and out comedy. And I think that's the beauty of the space right now.
Yeah, I think Indian production houses or companies like us, we've been producing slice of life content for the Indian audiences. And Netflix has brought in this different kind of storytelling, dystopian futures, alternate universes, bizarre environments, crazy characters, dark characters, and people are lapping up that too. So I think now the Indian audiences are getting to view best of both the worlds, and even comedy too. And now they appreciate all kind of content. So I think it's a balance and should stay that way.
Of course, not, no?
Yeah, at least on YouTube there shouldn't be. So it allows writers to just be free, be able to have children, be able to say fuck you or crude words in front of parents, which reflects a certain set of the society that ye hota hai, chalta hai kuch parents mein, they're okay and casual with their children. And otherwise, when you're writing dark stuff or comedy, people in normal day-to-day life do abuse, do use those expletives in any kind of expression of emotion, and that should be allowed for sure.
Yeah, agree.
Yeah, I think by the tradition, if second also has been well received, a third should be discussed, and hopefully very soon.
Thank you for giving it to us.
The space is so fast evolving. There's so much content being produced every month that it makes sense to acknowledge people who've done good in a quarter or in a month. So yeah, that's great. Keep them coming.
For all the latest updates
on web entertainment,
please log on to
thedigitalhash.com.